Let's take a look at some manual cable routing in Creo Parametric. First, I will orient you to my assembly. I have four different connectors in my model that I'm going to route some wires between, and a couple of clips down at the bottom of the tray that I am going to adjust the routing through. To get into cabling mode, I will click on Applications and then Cabling. And most of the icons in the ribbon are grayed out because I do not have a harness part currently. So to create my harness, I will go to the Create Harness button. And here we see part, and the subtype is set to harness. For lack of originality, I'm going to call it Harness 1 and then click OK. And now you can see I have my harness part at the bottom of my model tree. There is a little green diamond at the bottom of the icon indicating that it is the active harness, because you could have multiple different harnesses inside of an assembly. And if you want to change which harness you're working on, you go to the Modify Harness button. Now you notice that a lot more icons are available to me in the ribbon. The next thing that I'm going to do is designate the different components I'm going to use as connectors. Now, this isn't required, but I like to do this. Before I do that, though, I'm going to turn on the display of my columns. If I go to the type drop-down list, I can change to cabling info. I'm going to add a column for the designation. Let's crank up the width a bit and click the OK button. And here you can see that a couple of the connectors have already been designated, but this one hasn't, and neither has this one. So to designate those as cables for routing, we go to the drop-down list here from Auto Designate and then choose Designate. And then it's asking me to select a component for connector definition. Let me select this component over here. You could read in parameters from a file, but I'm just going to take the default values. And let's turn on the coordinate system visibility, because now I'm going to designate an entry port. I'll click on Entry Ports, and then we have the Add Modify command in the menu manager. I will select the entry coordinate system, then click OK. It asks me for the length of the cable inside of the connector. Right now my coordinate system is on the front surface. I need to account for a little bit of wiring going inside of the connector. I don't know what that value is, but I'm just going to guess a value. Let's say it's going to be a tenth of an inch. Now we have the choice of how we're going to use this. If this can accept only a single conductor, we would use the wire option. If you are going to take multiple different connectors, you could choose either round routing or flat. And this would most likely have flat routing. It would probably have multiple different pins located in there. So I will select that option for the grouping. And then I can just hit done and done out of here. So now we can see that we have a designation for this particular connector. And let me figure out which one isn't designated. Okay, that one over there. Let's repeat the designation process one more time. Designate, pick the component. I'm not going to read in any parameters from a file. And let's go to entry ports again. And I'll choose entry for this one. And then OK. Length of cable inside of there. Again, I'm just making up a value over here. And let's say that this is only going to accept one particular conductor. Let's choose wire and then done and done return. So there we have our different connectors designated. Now I'm going to create a spool that I'm going to use for routing. So we can click on spools, and here in the menu manager we can click create. And this is going to be a wire spool. Be aware that you can also create cable spools and sheaths and ribbons. But for wire, I'm going to enter in a spool name. I'm going to use 16AWG. And here we have the electrical parameters dialog box. We've got the name of our spool. Here we have wire. And for the thickness, this is actually going to be value of 0.05. Now we have our minimum bend radius. I've seen people use anywhere from 2 times the thickness to 8 times the thickness. Hopefully you have this information from your particular wire vendors. There are times when I've actually called up vendors and asked them, hey, what's the minimum bend radius? And they're like, what the heck are you talking about? So for this one, I'm going to use a value of 0.2. I'm going to use 4 times the thickness. And here we can specify what color it's going to have. If you give the color a name that actually exists in your file, that exists in your color map, then it'll actually use that. And I'm not sure if I have a color called blue, but I'm just going to type in blue anyways. So that is good. You are able to add additional columns in here. If I go to view and columns, here are all the different columns that are available to you. And one that you might want to add in here is the density. Now be aware that this density is a linear density, and that way it'll be able to calculate the mass of your wires based on their length and the linear density. Let's click OK out of here. And since I don't know what the linear density is, I'm just going to leave it non-existent for now. So this is good for my spool definition. I will click OK. And we can click Done Return out of the Spools menu. Now I am ready to route some wires. So to do that, we will go to the Route Cables command. And I'm going to just create a single individual wire feature to route. There is a default name, which you can change if you want. Here we have our spool. Even in this dialog box, you could create a new spool on the fly, but I'm going to use the standard spool. And for the routing, we have simple route. If I had some existing cables, I could follow that cable. Or here we have follow pipeline if you have some piping features created in your model. But I typically use simple route and then adjust the routing later on. And from the options drop-down menu, we have preview turned on. Here's where you can allow an undesignated coordinate system, and this is how you can skip the process of designating beforehand, and you can allow locations, and I'll show you what locations are in a moment. For routing the cable, we're going to choose a route, and I'll start it routing from this particular entry port, and then for the two, I will select this one over here, and there we have it created in here, and then we can click the OK button. And I'm happy with it so far. Now, to adjust the routing, I always like to turn on the display of my axes. And here we can see the preview of the wire. It's displayed in a thick cable display, but I can use this button to go to a centerline display. Then when I click on the particular wire, I can right-click on it and choose to insert locations. Here we have the drop-down list for the items panel, and right now there's where we can add different locations. I turn on the axis display so I could select this particular axis and then drag it out, and that way we get it going a little straighter out of the connector. That's good for that one. Let's hit the check mark, and that way I've just made it a little more like how I want it to look. And a lot of times when I'm cabling, I'm toggling between the centerline display and the thick cable display. All right, next up, let's create a couple of wires that go from the LCON connector to the ones on the left. Again, we will go to the Route Cables dialog box, and I'm going to click on the button to create an individual wire. Let's go from entry again. And this time I'm going to go to this particular coordinate system. Be aware that you can hold down the right mouse button. You get a pop-up menu where you can choose the to collector. We also have the options in here to allow locations, allow undesignated coordinate systems, and also for creating new different entities. But I'm happy with the to collector being active. And I will select this one over here. That is good. If I click the apply button, it resets the dialog box so I can create another wire going from this particular coordinate system to this one over here. And we see the preview. And again, I can click OK. And just like before, I can adjust the routing of this particular cable. So let's click on it. and then right mouse click and hold and choose to insert locations. And maybe I want to simulate that this wire is actually going to go down and be located a little bit off of this surface over here. So I can click on that location. You can see the preview of the routing. Maybe it's going to end up being routed along the side of the box. So there we see our next location. And if I hold down the right mouse button, I can change how I'm locating the next location point. If I choose use direction, then I can pick something like an edge in my model and then translate off of here some distance. And let's say I want it exactly value of 10 from there, from the previous location I've entered in the values. And it may be hard for you to see, but there are these little dots for the different locations that I have selected. And those are location points. So when I was routing, if I held down the right mouse button, I was able to change the option to use a location. Location are the different points along the routing. All right, for the next routing for this one, I can choose along axis and pick this axis from my clip. Let me just make sure I'm getting that routing axis. That right now it's being offset. Oh, actually still on use direction. Let me change to on. And if I go to the items tab, let's delete that one. And now we have a long axis selected. That's good. Let me change to this particular axis. And when you do a long axis, it's actually going to create two location points on both ends of the axis. And I'm just routing to make sure that long axis is still selected. That's good. Let me select this particular axis over here. And then for the next location points, I'm going to turn off the along axis and make sure that I'm still on the on option. And then let's say I wanted to go over here for the next location point. And then next location, use direction, and then pick this particular axis over there. Again, if I want to adjust the dimension, I can, or I can just drag it out and eyeball it to where it's going to be and leave it at that particular point. Now be aware when you are using the on option for these different location points, it's actually going to be located slightly off of the surface that you pick. So it's going to be a value of 0.6 times the wire. The center of the wire is going to be 0.6 times the wire diameter off the surface. In other words, there's going to be a clearance of 10% of the wire diameter between the outside of the wire and whatever surface that you select on. So this is good for this particular wire over here, and I can see the routing. And later on, I can adjust these different location points if I don't like how they are located. So for example, I can edit definition and say, hey, I want this more over here. So that's good for that particular one. And then adjust any other location points that I want. So for example, maybe I want this to be, hey, instead of negative 10, negative 9, that makes it look better. Great. And hit the check mark. And for this other particular wire, for routing it, since I've already defined a bunch of different location points in the previous wire that I routed, in the mini toolbar, we have this reroute command. And with the reroute command, we can follow the routing of other wires. And I can say, hey, let's start at this location to pick it up. And the end location, we'll pick the end location over there. So now we have both of those wires going along the same routing. So I can hit the check mark, change over to a thick cable display, and there you see the harness that I've created with the three individual wire conductors. And inside of the harness part, you can see that there are a bunch of different features. And here we have in the designation column the names of the three wires. And also, one last thing to point out, the spool that I created is actually an assembly level feature. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.